Hi, this is Mary Morrissey. Congratulations. You are on the front side of three videos that if you will just explore, be curious about, and consider, and then apply the things that we're going to talk about, you are going to see your life move in a more positive direction. As surely as you plant a seed, you nurture it, you are going to get the fruit of that seed, whatever it is. So it is with this kind of work we're doing now. So this first video is called How to Discover Your Dream. Now, a how-to gives methodology, it gives ways and means, and it is a way of replicating. There is a way how to build a house. There is a way how to drive a car. There is a way how to learn how to lift weights. And there is a way how to learn how to dream and discover your dream. Now, let's start for a moment. I want to give you a little personal history. It will be 40 years this October since I had a major breakthrough moment when I began to discover that there really is an invisible component for everything visible. That everything you can see right now, look around you, everything you can see has been created twice. First it was a thought before it could ever be a thing. In my room right now where I'm filming this, there's a desk, there's a chair, there's a couch, there's lamps, there's books, there's a bookshelf, there's a painting that someone did for me, there's all these things. But first, before they ever became the thing, they were an idea. And then that idea was acted upon. So every book in here was somebody's dream. This particular bookshelf was somebody's dream. That picture over there was somebody's dream. Now, it's not a major life-changing, life-altering dream, but I'm going to make a picture. I'm going to write a book. I'm going to build a bookshelf. And you are dreaming all the time. The challenge is that most of us think of dreaming as this huge big thing, like I've got to have this big dream for my life. And the art of learning how to dream is that as you begin to understand, and we're going to go through this in the three videos, the art and the science of dream building, that once you begin to understand the tools by which you build little dreams, bigger dreams, massive life-changing dreams, the skill set and the tools are all the same. It's how you tap into the invisible side of your nature where ideas dwell. How you learn to generate higher order ideas, ideas that actually you feel excited about, you feel happy about, you feel, I would love that. You have no idea how to do it, but you would love to have that happen. Now, this is a how-to video, how to discover your dream. Let's take the word discover for a moment and recognize that to discover means to uncover something, that it's already there, but now you've pulled off the cover so that you can actually see it. So this is based on an idea that if you look at our current understanding about the nature of our universe, we are in a spiral universe that is expanding. So everywhere present, there is this pull of ever freer, fuller becoming that's everywhere in the universe. It's inside you. That same pull of becoming will cause a blade of grass to press through the cement seeking the light. The Talmud said every blade of grass has an angel leaning over it whispering, grow, grow, grow. And that same life energy is saying to you, there's more to you, there's more for you. And we go through life and as little kids we know how to dream. I mean, we let ourselves try on all kinds of possible futures. Like, you know, I'm going to be a veterinarian. I'm going to be a ballerina. I'm going to be an astronaut. I'm going to be whatever it is. And we put on that possible future and we imaginally walk around in it for a while and we unconsciously and probably even out of our awareness, we're testing whether or not that fits us. My granddaughter Allie a few years ago put on, I'm going to be a veterinarian. And she wore that persona for a few weeks and was telling all of us she was going to be a veterinarian. And underneath that, she really longed for a puppy and hadn't had her own dog yet. And so she was putting on being a veterinarian, and then one night her family was sitting around having dinner and my daughter served, I don't know what she served, but some kind of meat. And Allie looked at that, and I think it was like a burger or something, and she goes, oh, if I'm a veterinarian, I'm going to be taking care of animals. I don't think I want to be eating animals if I'm taking care of them. And at that moment she goes, I don't think I'm going to be a veterinarian because then I'm also always going to be taking care of sick animals, and that's not really what I want to do. I want to be doing something else. So there's no right or wrong about which path you take. It's, is it more life-giving or not? So let's get into the how to discover your dream. So for a moment, let's take a deep breath. And I want to invite you to just join me in something, all right? For a moment, just notice your body. Notice the feeling of your clothing touching your body. Notice the feeling if you have shoes on, the shoes on your feet. Notice the feeling of the floor touching your feet. Notice your feet, your ankles, your knees, your thighs, your hips, your belly, your bottom, your back, your shoulders, your forearms, your elbows, your wrists, your fingertips, your chin, your nose, your cheeks, your head. Notice your body. And notice all the feeling of maybe the gentle air caressing your exposed skin. Notice your body. Then for a moment, notice your thoughts, what you've been thinking. You've been thinking while you're watching this video. Sometimes you're thinking about the content. You might be thinking about what you should have done before you got on the video, what you're going to do later. All kinds of thoughts are flowing through you without judgment. Just notice your thoughts. Then for a moment, notice what you've been feeling. If you've been feeling happy or sad or interested or bored, or no judgment, just notice what you've been feeling. Then ask yourself a question. Who is it in me that can notice my body but is not my body? If I lose a hand, I don't say I lost me. I say I lost my hand. Who is that? Who is that that can notice my thoughts but could actually say yes or no to a thought? Say, I'm not going to think that thought. Or indulge or dwell in a line of thinking. Who is that that gets to choose what thought you're going to think? And when you notice your emotion or your feeling, who is it that can say, I'm not going to be angry about that. I'm going to choose to change my thinking about that. Who is that? Because your emotion is always your conscious awareness of the vibration you're in. So who is it that can notice your body but's more than your body? Who is it that can notice your thoughts but is never contained or controlled by a thought, actually chooses a thought? Who is it that can notice their emotion but can say yes or no to amplifying or releasing an emotion? Who is that? That is the authentic you. And that life force, that soul, that pattern, that being that you are, is having a human experience. And there is so much more to you than you've ever known, and you contain far much more than you've ever thought. And no matter where we are in the spiral of becoming, no matter how much learning we've gained, no matter how far we've gone, there is still the more seeking to emerge. Hildegard de Bingen, a 13th century Christian mystic, said, every single one of us must learn to live on the green growing edges of our own becoming. Now, I came from the Northwest. We have green all year long, but in the spring, when the new growth comes out, it's a different color green. There's something seeking to emerge by you. It's your life. Now, your dream is not a heavy to-do. It's something wanting to birth itself. It's wanting something to come forth. It could be travel. It could be a new home. It could be remodeling your home. It could be more depth in a relationship you're in. It could be healing a relationship that you feel out of sorts with. It could be all kinds of things, but it's life seeking to emerge by means of you. Now, how do you know what your dream is? How do you discover that? You start where you are with what you have. And what you have right now is a system of information that is reflective of the life you're living. Some of the life you're living right now you absolutely love, probably. Maybe there's parts of it you love a whole lot. So, and if you pay attention to your life and you look at your life, there may be parts of your life where there's longing or discontent. It could be in the area of money, in relationship, in health, in what you do with your time and talent, what your days look like, are you free to travel? And if you pay attention, there will be a longing in you for freedom in the areas of life that matter to you. That will speak to you both through longing, and that same energy will speak to you through discontent. I'm tired of trying to figure out, hey, how to pay the bills every month. I'm tired of this. I spoke to a woman this morning and she said, I am so tired of, and then she described a phase of her life. Well, that discontent is the voice of the bigger part of her seeking to emerge. But if she doesn't understand how the invisible side of her nature becomes visible, she will just stay in that spot where she's tired of it, but she doesn't know how to change it. It's like having your television on CNN And you're really tired of CNN. You're tired of the drama. You're tired of the trauma. You're tired of the difficulty. But you don't know how to get off CNN and get on Discovery, on travel, on home and garden, on romance, whatever it is. Well, these videos are meant to give you some very solid steps. So here's the first step in the how to discover your dream. Stand on the premise that there are dreams seeking to emerge by means of you. They don't have to be big life-changing dreams. As you begin to discover the technology, which I will give you in these videos, you're going to begin to build some things in your life, open to some ideas, and you're going to begin to understand that every single day you're building tiny dreams. I'm going to get to the office. That's a tiny dream. I'm going to call my mother. That's a tiny dream. You had an idea, and you translated that invisible side of your nature into a visible experience. You're doing it all the time. You're just not aware of how you're serving the ideas that come to your mind, which ones you serve, which ones you don't. So for today, let's recognize that I'm choosing to serve ideas, and I could give myself permission to explore ideas I would love to serve but have no idea how to do it. So right now, it's a clean slate. I don't care what's happened in your life. I don't care what your financial position looks like. I don't care any of the facts. And I can promise you, I've worked with tens of thousands of people. And these principles work if we work them. Now, just like electricity, I can't make it work your way. I can't make electricity work my way. I have to study the law of electricity and work in harmony with it. But when I do study it, and when I learn to work in harmony with it, I can have light wherever I want. When I learn to focus that light, I can have laser and cut through steel. There's not one problem you have that's bigger than what we're going to be talking about here. And there's not one dream you have that cannot come about. Versions of it, ways and means of it that I'll show you how to do. But the beginning part is you have to be willing to consider this fact. I've been serving dreams all along. I just perhaps haven't given myself permission to dream dreams or think up ideas that give me life, that light me up. So let's go back to the 3-year-old self and the 4-year-old self that knew how to dream. And just for today, walk around all day and say, if I were living a life I loved living, what would that life be like? Not if you think you can, if you have the money for it, not those questions. For today, put them, the person who can choose what you're going to think, put them aside. The how I'm going to do it for today is not the question. The what would I love is the right question. That is a power question to put into the Google box of your mind and your heart. What life would I love if I really could live any life I loved living? What would it be like? What would it look like? And there's 4 domains where you want to ask that question. What would I love in my health? What would I love in my relationships? What would I love and what I do with my time and talent? Where would I live? What would I be doing? Where would I be going? What would I be giving? And what would be the economic condition of my life to live a life that I love living? Give yourself permission and full permission to just discover an idea of what you would love. And then come back to video 2 and I'll show you the next step.